If any of these decorations fall mid-filming, I'm gonna leave them on the floor. Today on the channel, should I just leave them down? All right, let's set up. Hey guys, what's up? Welcome or welcome back to the channel. If you are new here, my name is Shanelle. I'm so happy to see you here today. Thank you so much for clicking on my video. It is the holidays on my reaction and commentary channel. I'm so excited. Love the holidays. Who doesn't? I mean, okay, I'm sure there's plenty of people who don't love the holidays. For once, can I just say something and stick to it? Like, does everything need a qualifier, Shan? I don't know. Welcome to my reaction and commentary channel. This is a channel where we watch the movies together. I chit-chat through them, let you know what's going on in my brain as I'm watching them. I love film. I love to call out filmmakery elements, filmmaker stuff, really cool shots, awesome color choices. And then when all is said and done, I gave my wrap up and we look at the IMDb movie trivia section together where I figure out what I missed, where I laugh because I was wrong. This is a safe space. This is a channel where you are allowed to be wrong and you are allowed to post it for thousands to see because we check it at the end. I can't believe that I've been talking for 4 minutes and 13 seconds already, and I haven't mentioned that today's video is Miracle on 34th Street, the original, the 1947 Miracle on 34th Street. I was obsessed with the 90s version when I was a kid. It was my favorite Christmas movie, probably my favorite movie at the time. I watched it nonstop around the clock. I love little Mara Wilson and Elizabeth Perkins, and oh my God, it was such magic. Last year when I posted Miracle on 34th Street, you guys can click it in the cards, I'll put it up there. When I watched Miracle on 34th Street last year, everyone was like, what's wrong with you? You have to see the original, like you're being stupid, Shan. At the time on my channel last year, I was doing a lot of rewatches because that's why I started my channel, actually, if you didn't know that. I started this channel to make it a rewatch channel. And then very quickly, I realized I wanted to do more and I had more to give, so to speak. So I'm so excited for today's watch, Miracle on 34th Street. Because I'm so familiar with the 90s version, I'm gonna like try to look and see how similar they are, how different they are. I'm gonna be really intrigued on what, you know, what became of the 90s version. It looks like the same storyline. It looks like the divorced mother, single mother hires Santa Claus and then we're gonna question his sanity, and it looks like we might even do the courtroom thing. Yeah, so as always, link in the description box below for Patreon information if you want more from me, other ways to support the channel down below. If you're thinking of buying some gear for a fellow YouTuber in your life, I have my gear linked below with an Amazon affiliate link. Make a teeny tiny commission when you use my link to buy whatever you need. And yeah, I don't want to drag this out any further. I'm so excited. Without further ado, let's get right into today's watch, which is Miracle on 34th Street from 1947. Maureen O'Hara, John Payne, Miracle on 34th Street. Okay, right off the bat, aspect ratio is a perfect square. I don't know if this was made for TV or if this was meant for the theaters, but this is what I know is like TV ratio. Number two, old-timey New York, which I love.
You've got them mixed up.
Oh, he looks jolly.
You're making a mistake.
Get your shit together, bro.
But I wanted to tell you, you're making a rather serious mistake.
Huh?
With the reindeer, I mean. And Dasho. Oh, Dasho should be on my right-hand side.
So in the 90s version, I think Richard Attenborough does that. He's singing Jingle Bells on the Street. And a little boy goes to his dad, ask him if he's Santa.
You're on float number three.
Wow. I love this movie. Is he drunk? Like the 90s version? Yeah.
Say it's all in the wrist. Yes, of course. It's pillow through, you know.
It's all in the wrist.
Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the day.
Could you be Santa Claus? Have you had any experience?
Oh, a little.
Just a little.
Get that costume.
So like back in the day, the camera wasn't as mobile. So I'm seeing a lot of wide shots. Camera is just following the action with a pan.
I beg your pardon.
And then they reserve those close-ups and coverage for the really important moments.
Could you be Santa Claus? Have you had any experience?
Pardon?
Oh, if I want to, which I doubt. I can see it from the roof of my apartment.
Well, that's right. You live down with the... Mrs. Walker!
I can't wait to see little Susan, my favorite character in the history of cinema. I wanted to be her.
Susan!
See, the camera's in one spot and it's just following her.
Where? With whom?
With that Mr. Gailey who lives in the front apartment.
Oh, him.
He was a clown last year. They just changed the head and painted him different. My mother told me.
Certainly is a giant, isn't he?
Not really. There are no giants, Mr.
Maybe not now, Susie, but in olden days there were a lot of...
She's like, don't. Don't even.
Well, that baseball player certainly looks like a giant to me.
People sometimes grow very big, but that's abnormal.
So the conversation is different, but we get the same vibe. She's precocious, and she doesn't believe in magic.
It's much better than last year's.
Well, I hope Mr. Macy agrees with you.
Oh, yeah, in the 90s version, they weren't allowed to use Macy's. They used Kohl's.
This one was a last-minute substitute. The one I hired, I fired.
Why?
You remember the way the janitor was last New Year?
Oh, yes.
Well, this...
She remembers.
Completely truthful with our children. And not have them growing up believing in a lot of legends and myths like Santa Claus,
I'm obsessed
example.
With her voice, her diction, her articulation. I'm not familiar if Maureen O'Hara is doing the Mid-Atlantic thing, that standard American Mid-Atlantic dialect, or if she's British. She's Irish. Oh my God, she's a redhead? 34th and 7th, baby, Macy's. Still there, still there.
Yeah, I play Santa Claus over at the wine near our block, see?
No kidding. Started about 3 years ago.
That's the second time I heard tree, that for T-H, tree. She said she did it too.
It makes me feel kind of good and important.
Let me give you a few tips on how to be a good Santa Claus.
Go right ahead.
Well, here.
Let's hear it.
You immediately suggest one
Nintendo.
Of these items.
Oh.
You understand?
I certainly do.
Xbox 360.
It's the way they commercialize Christmas.
Yeah, there's a lot of bad isms floating around this world, but one of the worst is commercialism. Even in Brooklyn, it's the same.
Oh, Brooklyn. That's what he's doing. He's doing Brooklyn.
I get kind of tired just sweeping up.
Like a Newsies accent.
Fine, just dislike the big ones. Only smaller has roses.
Macy's ain't got any. Nobody's got any.
Well, Peter, I can tell you're a good boy. You'll get your fire engine.
She's like, ah. Oh.
Only $8.50, a wonderful bargain.
Schoenfels, I just don't get it.
Don't question it, Bobo.
Imagine a big outfit like Macy's putting the spirit of Christmas ahead of the commercial. Well, I'll tell you, I never done much shopping here before, but I'll tell you one thing. From now on, I'm going to be a regular Macy customer.
That shouldn't be emotional. That was weird.
Thought as long as we're in the store, you might as well say hello to Santa Claus.
Why?
Because when you talk to him, you might feel differently about him.
She's great. She's like...
Oh, go ahead. Pull it.
Uh-oh. She's gonna be like, what are you doing?
I tell her Santa Claus is a myth, and you bring her down here, and she sees hundreds of gullible children, meets a very convincing old man with real whiskers. What is she going to think? Whom is she going to believe?
I'm kind of for the logic. Like, don't lie to your children.
Keep waiting for Prince Charming to come along. When he does, he turns out to be a...
We were talking about Susie now.
Oh, is she a feminist? She an early feminist? I'm down.
Well, young lady, and what's your name?
I'm sorry, she doesn't speak English.
Oh, this is the deaf girl. I love this moment in the 90s one.
Ich bin blij, dass ihr gekommen bin.
Oh, Ben Sinterklaas.
Yes, I guess Ich.
Ich wüsste wel. Ich will allein mal my days to leave for domicile.
That doesn't sound like native, though. It doesn't. That sounds American.
Danke, Sinterklaas.
Cool. I like that they switched it up in the newer one.
When he spoke Dutch to that girl, he...
Dutch.
Susan, I speak French, Dutch. But that doesn't make me Joan of Arc.
What I'm trying to explain to you is...
That is my real name. Second grade?
It's a progressive school.
Oh, it's a progressive school.
May I have this gentleman's employment card, please?
Yes, Mrs. Walker.
Here it is, Mrs. Walker. Oh, thank you.
What else do you do besides read?
North Pole next of kin. That's too good. I'm old as my tongue, a little bit older than my teeth. Brooks Memorial Home for the Aged. Great Neck, Long Island.
Have I done something wrong?
Oh, no. No.
Just a little bit. For me.
If we haven't got exactly what the customer wants, we'll send him where he can get it. No high pressure.
That reaction shot, they both were like...
If we haven't got exactly...
But first, get that Santa Claus back. The examination won't be worth a thing without the patient.
This is so theatrical. Like, the exposition is like theater.
Oh, Christmas isn't just a day. It's a frame of mind. And that's what's been changing.
Christmas is a frame of mind.
A mental examination?
Well,
I don't mind. I've taken dozens of them. How many fingers do you see?
Four.
Muscular coordination test.
How much 3 times 5?
Oh, you asked me that before. You'll find the answer right there at the bottom of the...
I'm conducting this examination.
3. Oh, you bite your nails too. Are you happy at home, Mr. Sawyer?
That will be all, Mr. Kringle.
Flip it on Mr. Sawyer. Let's go. Analyze him. I'm ready.
He was even questioning me. He should be placed in a mental institution.
Oh, I don't agree, Mr.
Just like that? Okay.
Well, I know Chris always carries a cane, but surely you're not implying he'd use the cane as a weapon.
That's exactly what I'm implying. And that's exactly what we're going to bait him to do.
If there's the slightest possibility of his becoming violent or getting into any trouble, I
couldn't possibly... What trouble could he get into?
A big argument? Clang, clang, Bellevue.
They're really grasping at straws here.
Do you think he'd agree to that?
I'll talk to him. I'm sure he will.
In that case, he can stay.
In like the 90s version, it's much more understated.
And I'll call you as soon as my wife's plastered. Feeling gay.
Oh, no.
Now,
I'm
really,
I'll call you as soon as my wife's plastered. Stop it.
He said, only animals allowed here. Goodbye. So it came upstairs.
Why didn't you tell him you were a lion or a bear?
She's
because
phenomenal.
Because I'm not a bear.
She's such a good little actress.
Mr. Kringle?
That's not what a monkey sounds like, you guys.
I was just thinking, I'm all alone in my apartment. Twin beds, plenty of room.
Twin beds, plenty of room.
Mr. Gailey, it's a deal.
Good. We'll drive out after dinner and get your things.
Hello?
No. Oh, dear.
Flip it, babe.
That's very sweet of them. Please thank them very much, but I'm going to stay with Mr. Gailey.
Mr. Gailey.
I think I'd better get the meat.
Mr. Gailey! She wants the house, right? Yep.
If you're really Santa Claus, you can get it for me. Guess you can't get it, huh?
I didn't say that.
Babe! Guess you can't get it. Well... In the early 90s version, she wants a dad, a house, and a brother. This feels easy, Kringle. This one feels like a piece of cake.
A little more effort on your part, and she might crawl out of that shell. Take her out to dinner in the theater.
Did grown men really have 2 twin beds in their apartments back in the day? Susan with this
now,
gum. This is
sing
so
you a little
funny.
Goodnight song?
If you want to.
I don't remember her chewing gum in the 90s version.
I just think it's kind of nice. Do you like Market?
All right.
She's so good at playing hard to get. She's like, all right, fine, whatever. I miss gum.
Well, here goes.
Gum was currency in middle school. You could get whatever you wanted if you had gum. Be like, you want a piece? Oh, they didn't show us.
Oh, ah.
Hilarious. We all have a gum in the hair horror story. Comment below. You gotta say it. Let me know.
Something is wrong. What is it?
What's wrong, Brooklyn?
Guys who dress up like Santa Claus, see, and do it because when they was young, they must have did something bad. So now they do something they think is good to make up for it, see?
Interesting points, though. Is there true altruism? I don't know. Do we act good for the sake of acting good?
Yes. What else has he found wrong with you, Alfred?
Oh, just that I hate my father. I didn't know it, but he says I do.
There's only one way to handle a man like you.
Oh! Oh, that's the move.
I don't think we can take any chances, really, I don't.
It's a good-looking bump.
He passes the test, he can return to work immediately.
This is going to hurt Chris very deeply, and I don't want to be the one to do it.
Yes. Stick to your guns, baby.
Where to? Bellevue.
No! Bellevue.
You deliberately failed that examination, didn't you?
Why?
They have a scene like this in the 90s version.
She didn't want to hurt you. But only because I was a nice, kind old man and she was sorry for me.
That's not true.
He's called normal and I'm not. But if that's normal, I don't want it. That's why I answered the questions incorrectly.
Can't let them down.
You're right. I ought to be ashamed of myself. Even if we can't win, we can go down swinging.
Forgetting you flunked your examination, but good.
Oh, yes.
Whoops, forgot.
I suppose I'll have to read all this.
Take my word for it. Just routine commitment papers, cut and dried. The man calls himself Chris Kringle. Thinks he's Santa Claus.
They do this in the 90s version, too. He goes, do I have to read this? And I'm literally like, it's your job, buddy.
Of course, you may sign the commitment papers now if you wish, Your Honor. But I shall bring in habeas corpus this afternoon.
There's no point in signing. Monday morning at 10 o'clock.
Yes, this is exactly what happens in the other movie. Very faithful adaptation, if I do say so myself.
We're very anxious to avoid publicity of any kind.
Naturally.
So if you would agree to put this matter through quietly, I'm...
He's gonna make it huge. Get the whole city involved.
You know, if I'm gonna win this case, I'm gonna have to have public opinion and plenty of it.
Publicity, baby.
Scoot. Now, how about a great big kiss for Grandpa,
You're prosecuting Santa, you dummy.
I believe he was employed to play Santa Claus. Perhaps he didn't understand the question correctly.
Oh, I understood the question perfectly, Your Honor.
The judge is looking for the out. Like, how do I acquit? How do I rule Thank that he's you. Sane? Help me out, bro.
And either I drop this impossible case immediately, or they will drop me.
See?
I beat him to it. I quit.
Fred, you didn't.
Of course I did.
I love this man. I love him so much.
Plans. Then you go on an idealistic binge. You give up your job, you throw away all your security, and then you
Throw away. She's doing the TH thing too.
Look, Doris, someday you're going to find out that your way of facing
That's
this realistic
so
world just doesn't work. And when you do, don't overlook those lovely intangibles.
And they have this faith, believe in what you can't see, faith discussion in the 1990, what is it, 4 version? I was just thinking about how rare is it to be shooting on location in New York at this time, in 1947.
Do you really believe that this man is Santa Claus?
Well, I... I do.
Just got a little bit of chills. They're starting. A little bit. I really like this story.
Will Thomas Mara please take the stand?
Who, me?
Thomas Mara Jr.
Ha ha. Get the kids.
Hello, Daddy.
Hello, Father.
Do you believe in Santa Claus, Tommy?
Sure I do. There he is, sitting there.
Your Honor, I protest.
Overruled.
Ha ha, that performance. Overruled.
Because my daddy told me so. Didn't you, Daddy? My daddy wouldn't tell me anything that wasn't so. Would you, Daddy? But I've got a feeling he is Santa Claus, Mother.
Some people don't believe that. That's why they're having
But he's so kind and nice and jolly. He's not like anyone else. He must be Santa.
I always love when they get Susan on board.
Then I'm going to write him a letter right now and cheer him up.
I just have such a soft spot for this movie. I really just, wow.
I seen him ride to Santa Claus, North Pole, South Pole, and every other place. Here's a kid writes, Chris Kringle, New York County Courthouse. Can you
remember? It'd be kind of nice to get rid of him.
Get him to the courthouse.
The Post Office Department was created by the Second Continental Congress on July 26, 1776. Last year, under Robert Hannigan, it did a gross business of $1,112,877,174.
Clap for the Postal Service.
Your Honor, the state of New York is second to none in its admiration of the Post Office Department. It is efficient, authoritative, and prosperous. We are very happy to concede Mr. Gailey's claim.
Are you sure?
I have further exhibits, Your Honor, but I hesitate to produce them.
Oh, I'm sure we'll be...
Bring them in. It's a symbolic hearing. Too good.
A branch of the federal government recognizes this man, Chris Kringle, to be the one and only Santa Claus.
This court will not dispute it. Case dismissed.
I had to wait to tell you. I got your note. It made me very happy.
Oh, I'm so glad.
Now, how does he get Susan her house?
Mr. Mason.
Alfred, he'll make a great Santa one day. One day. Not now. This isn't his time. Yet. What is that? What did he get?
I don't suppose you even want to talk to me.
Something about a present.
Yes, I know.
Can we talk about Santa Claus's belt being essentially right under his boobs?
Faith is believing in things when common sense tells you not to.
Huh?
I mean... You've still got to believe in people.
I thought so.
Dory has faith now.
But I believe.
Thanks, Chris. I'll be fine.
They're gonna find the house. They're gonna go see the house.
Stop, Uncle Fred! Stop! Stop! Stop!
Susie!
It's the house from the picture.
Ah! But this is my house, Mommy. The one I asked Mr. Kringle for. It is it, and you were right, Mommy. Mr. Kringle is Santa Claus.
Where are you going?
You told her that.
I did not know they were going to kiss. No.
I never really doubted you. It was just...
I did not see that coming. They did not really build out their romance at all. But I'm dead. They kiss.
I take a little old man and legally prove to the world that he's Santa Claus. Now, you know that...
Oh, no, it can't be. It must have been left here by the people that moved out.
Maybe I didn't do such a wonderful thing after all.
That was so sweet. I love that movie. Miracle on 34th Street from 1947. I've loved the 90s film for so long. It is my absolute favorite must-watch of the season. I'm obsessed with that movie. I was obsessed with it growing up, and now I have seen its predecessor. I'm obsessed with this movie. I love the themes of like having faith, and especially around the holidays, and just like the magic of Christmas, the spirit of Christmas, taking a young impressionable girl and like managing to change her mind. And I'm so happy to see the first film that started it all. And then I know I'm gonna have my own bias because I'm obsessed with it, but I think that the 90s film does a brilliant job bringing the story to a modern crowd. I would have never picked up the 1947 version when I was a kid, but I picked up the Mara Wilson version because I love her. And then you can deliver this story to whomever needs it. Yeah, so I enjoyed this so much, and it was such magic and such fun, and the performances are pretty next level and amazing, and little Natalie Wood is so good, and Catherine O'Hara is so good, and the man who plays Santa himself, so good, so cute. I just love this story. I'll watch it time and time again. It's absolutely timeless, and watching it from 1947 did not bother me one bit. But yeah, brilliant, gorgeous, so emotional, such a crowd pleaser for the holidays. I would show this to my family, my kids, forever. This is the one. If you're gonna watch anything during the holidays, I vote Miracle on 34th Street, for certain. Okay, let's do some world-famous trivia. In the untranslated dialogue with the Dutch girl, Chris asks her what she wants. She says she wants nothing, telling him she got her gift by being adopted by her new mother. Cute. I was gonna say, oh my god, shooting on location in New York had to have been rare. It's more done now, but it's cold. So this fact. The film was shot during a bitterly cold New York winter. On several occasions, the cameras literally froze. Maureen O'Hara remembered that a woman named Vaughn Mele lived across the street from where they were shooting exteriors and allowed the crew to warm up in her house. In gratitude, O'Hara took her and her husband to the famed 21 restaurant. She was so excited, all she could drink was a glass of milk. Funny. House at the end of the film is a 1,700 square foot single family home built in 1943 at 24 Derby Road, Port Washington, New York. It looks practically the same as it did then, except the roof line has been altered by the addition of a window. Oh my gosh, Edmund Gwenn played Santa Claus in the actual Macy's Thanksgiving Day Parade held November 28th, 1946. That's so cute. According to Natalie Wood's biographer, during the shoot, she was convinced that Edmund Gwenn was actually Santa Claus. Maureen O'Hara's time with Natalie Wood was something she always treasured. I've been the mother to almost 40 children in movies, but I've always had a special place in my heart for little Natalie, she said. She always called me Mama Maureen and I called her Natasha, the name her parents had given her. Oh, that's so cute. Yeah, Maureen, wow, Natalie Wood was Russian. Is Russian. Both Macy's and Gimbel's were approached by the producers for permission to have them depicted in the film. Both wanted to see the finished film first before they gave approval. If either had refused, the film would have had to have been extensively edited and reshot to eliminate the references. Fortunately, at the test viewing, both were pleased with the film and gave their permission. Phew. Huh. Edmund Gwenn gained 30 pounds to play Chris. Wow. The scenes at Macy's were shot on location at the main store on 34th Street itself. Shooting was complicated by the fact that the crew's power needs exceeded the store's electricity capacity and required additional power sources arranged in the basement. Wow. Edmund Gwenn improvised his reaction to the beard pull, so Natalie Wood would be surprised. Cute. Wow, I didn't even know this was a thing. The film received a B rating, morally objectionable in part, which means morally objectionable in part, from the highly influential Legion of Decency because Maureen O'Hara played a divorcee. So funny. Not funny that she's divorced, just funny. Robert Hyatt came up with his "because my daddy told me so" line. Dead.
Because my daddy told me so.
Scenes of the Macy's Thanksgiving Day Parade are of the actual parade held in 1946. As such, careful preparation was necessary for the shots, as retakes were obviously out of the question. Unusually, there were two Christmas films nominated for Best Picture at the 1947 Academy Awards. This one and Henry Coster's The Bishop's Wife. They join It's a Wonderful Life from 1946, the year before, as the only three Christmas movies to be nominated for Best Picture. Oh, that means a lot. That's cool. They insisted this movie be released in May because more people go to the movies during the summer, so the studio began scrambling to promote it while keeping the fact that it was a Christmas movie a secret. Oh my god, so they wanted to lure people to the cinemas to see this in May. Film grossed over four times its budget. Okay, I think that this confirms then that this was shot for the cinemas. We'll look up aspect ratio stuff. Okay, the 4:3 standard. The 4:3 ratio for standard television has been in use since the invention of moving picture cameras and many computer monitors used to employ the same aspect ratio 4:3. This was the aspect ratio used for 35 millimeter films in the silent era. It is also very close to the 1.3751 Academy ratio defined by the Academy of Motion Picture Arts and Sciences as a standard after the advent of optical sound on film. By having TV match this aspect ratio, movies originally photographed on 35mm film could be satisfactorily viewed on TV in the early days of the medium, i.e. during the 40s and the 50s. Okay, so I'm pretty sure this movie would have a 4:3 ratio. Yeah, so this is very standard ratio for the time, and it wasn't different from TV to movie. It was the same. I said this. The Dutch girl spoke true Dutch, but with a heavy American accent. It sounded very, very American. Unusual for a major studio film, I did notice this. There was Bugs Bunny everywhere. Characters identified with a competing studio, Warner Brothers, Bugs Bunny, Beaky Buzzard, etc., are prominently featured on the walls of Macy's Santa Claus display. Yes. Oh my god, the real R.H. Macy died in 1877, 70 years before the time of the film. I didn't think of that at all. I wasn't like, that's weird. He's alive. Wow. The rivalry between Macy's and Gimbel's depicted in this film was very real. They were just blocks from each other in New York, major competitors for the same business. Wow, this film was one of the first ones colorized in 1985, resulting in some controversy and an uproar from the film purists. So Edmund Gwenn won an Academy Award for his portrayal of Santa. Okay, yeah, I didn't really have too many questions. I did want to know where they shot, and it looks like they did shoot on location in New York City, and it was very cold for them. They used the real Macy's exteriors, the real stores. Very cool. I would love a documentary or just some information on how they adapted this old one into the 90s version, because I don't think it's an easy feat. It's not an easy task to rewrite this. And some choices that they made were genuinely astonishing. Like, they didn't play, a lot of the beats are the same, but then the ones that were different were very cool. Like Fred Gailey using the letters in this one, and then in the 90s version he uses, oh my god, Jack Albertson is post office mail sorted, that's Grandpa Joe, right? I'm getting so distracted, I'm so sorry, can you follow me? I love the rewrites because it's so nice that they didn't just take Girl Who Speaks Dutch and then do Santa speaking Dutch in the newer one. They did Santa Speak Sign Language. I love how in the original it's the letters getting dumped on the desk, and in the newer one it's the In God We Trust circled that lets Judge off the hook. If the state of New York and the United States of America has no, like, doesn't have to prove that there's a God to put it on their currency, then this man can be Santa. I think. Filming locations. Manhattan, 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 Manhattan. Okay, yes. Stage 3, 20th Century Fox Studios in Century City. Stage 6 in Century City. And then exteriors in Manhattan. Amazing, amazing, amazing. Yeah, I mean, I'll just leave you with this. Every time I watch Miracle on 34th Street, I'm a believer again. And what more could you ask for? It's absolute magic. This is the most magical movie I know. I can't think of anyone more magical. Sorry, all you It's a Wonderful Life heads out there. I'm a Miracle on 34th Street girl. Close second place is It's a Wonderful Life. This one hits home more for me. I don't know why. In any case, an absolute piece of magic. So happy that I saw this. So you've seen my reaction to Miracle on 34th Street from 1947. Let me know what you thought. Where were you the first time you saw this? Did somebody in your life show it to you? Where did you see it in theaters? Did you see it on television? What did you think? Did it make you a believer? Anyone out there who's seen the 94 version? Don't quote me on that. What do you think of that one? How do you think they stack up? I'm absolutely so thankful for the 90s version for delivering me this movie in the way I wanted to see it, with, you know, someone I related to as Susan, Mara Wilson, and now I'm an adult and I can see the original, and I love it. I love it. This is one of my favorite things to do on the channel. I don't think we've ever done it. I don't think I've ever done a remake before. So that's exciting. As always, if you want more from me, Patreon information in the description box below. Other ways to support the channel in the description box below. And on that note, as always, I'm gonna go eat.